Rachel is a senior curator of exhibition at the Art Galleries. She holds an MA in exhibition and museum studies from the San Francisco Art Institute and a BFA from the School of Art Institute of Chicago. Her interests include the crossover between art and architecture, new media and video art and performance in non-traditional spaces. Since arriving in Buffalo in March 2015, she has curated exhibitions, Splitting Light, The Visitors, and Cracked Open, 40 Years of Work by David Schrim. Currently on view at both galleries is Linda O'Kerma's exhibition Situations, which actively challenges viewers to question their perception of space or sculptures, installation, and works on paper that blur the line between two and three dimensions. The catalog is forthcoming. Rachel.
So when I first arrived in Buffalo in March 2015 from Austin, Texas, my immediate reaction was like, oh my God, there's history here. I'm like, Austin, especially architectural history. And as I started to spend time driving around the city, I became enamored not only by the architecture of the neighborhoods, but especially the green silos. I've always been interested in the intersection of art and architecture, but I wasn't interested in doing an exhibition about women porn. I hate that phrase and I think it's horrible. I was a visitor for a studio at UB Architecture School that Joyce ran, which was about reusing the silos. And that rehabbing the silos into mixed-use buildings, and that sort of inspired an idea. There was a student in the notes from Buffalo, and he spoke with such reverence about how these buildings are not an eyesore, and about that, how they're the history and innovation of this great city. So I thought about how do we honor the things that we no longer need. For me, I came across a concrete Atlantis through an artist that I was visiting, and basically putting together for 2018 an exhibition called Elemental Forms, the Presence of Industrial Architecture in Contemporary Art, which examines the historical relevance of industrial structures while showcasing contemporary artists to create new narratives. So as I was putting together this exhibition, looking at the book, Patricia Bazelon, who actually taught at UB, did all the photography for Greater Banner's book. So she was sort of somebody that I immediately wanted to include in the exhibition. And actually, we just got a donation from the galleries of her work, so that was really exciting. And then I sort of started going back, looking at Charles Sheeler's River Rouge Plant Series, which he photographed for Henry Ford in 1927 or in the 20s. And just really thinking about like the forms and looking at things, sort of how they become abstracted within photography. Moving on to Byrne and Hillard Becker, I don't know if anyone is familiar with their work, but as you can see in the lower right-hand corner, they actually come to Buffalo and photograph the H.O. Oates grain silo. And then sort of the exhibition takes a couple of, sort of in three sections. So there's the photography section, and then there's sort of the form section. So looking at Charlotte Posnansky's work, she was really interested in these forms within architecture. So she created these modular pieces that you can actually put together yourself, sort of about how the viewer can like put together different forms within these modular system. This is an exhibition in New York. She passed away, unfortunately, but her estate still allows you to basically fabricate forms. Sahar Shah is an artist that's based in India, and her practice works with drawing, sculpture, and photographs. And she uses sort of drawing as a translation of attitudes toward architecture, but also looking at modernist architecture, utopian city plans, and historical spectacles. So Ben Peterson is the artist that introduced me to Rainer Banham, and these are actually concrete, ceramic works to make to look like concrete forms, looking again, sort of like Charlotte's work, at like ductwork and things that you might not see necessarily. Julie Weber is an artist living in LA, and this is sort of small tabletop work that are models for his Demon Hill series. And the Demon Hill series looks at gravitational mystery spots. I don't know if anyone's familiar with those, but as part of the exhibition, we are planning to build one of these in full scale. And it's actually sort of a reference to like the vertigo that might happen if you're standing like right next to a grand style and look up. So this will be a piece that we will build from one of his models that people can actually go inside. So when you go inside, your perception is completely off because the way that the building is angled. Those people are actually standing up completely straight, but they feel like they're actually leading. It'll be really fun. Moving into the third portion of the exhibition, Amy Siegel's film Quarry is a study of the world's largest marble quarry in Vermont. So actually, she went into the marble quarry and filmed all the machines sort of pulling out the marble, and then following the trace of it, going to these very high-rise residences in New York City and filming inside where the marble actually ends up. Ante Liu utilizes the garbage of industry, so packaging found around consumer products such as computers, electronics, and toys. So thinking about like how industry has changed and then casting those, you know, sort of styrofoam pieces into sculptures. And then finally, City Souvenirs is a participatory work that Lena Bosque does, where you can actually take wet porcelain and go around the city and sort of make a mold. So this is sort of something in terms of like a public program that would happen with the exhibition, where we go to industrial sites, industrial historical sites in Buffalo and make molds. And I just really love this quote, a bare practical form becomes abstract beauty, because when I'm thinking about this exhibition, I'm really thinking about how contemporary artists are looking back on these forms that were sort of accidental architecture that came across, and then sort of molding them into something that, you know, is still relevant today.